Hello everyone, hope you all are doing well. So in this video, I'll be giving you a brief demo of Toucan, and which is basically a delivery management platform and one of the products of Jungleworks product suite. So let's first go through the contents of this demo video. So first I'll be covering what is Toucan, then who are the stakeholders of Toucan, then how to create a task, how to assign a task, and then we'll go walk you through a task journey. Then we'll discuss all the features mentioned on the dashboard, and finally we'll go through all the features which are included in the settings section of Toucan. So without any delay, let's first start with what is Toucan. So Toucan is basically a delivery management platform which handles the end-to-end journey of any online order that starts from a order booking from the customer, then assignment to an agent, then creation of routes and navigation for the agent, and then tracking of the agents as well, which is shared with the customers as well as the admin who's handling the business. And these orders can vary from various use cases, very simple as food delivery to home services, or like any field force management where your sales people are basically working in the field. So there can be various use cases, and all those cases can be handled on Toucan. So this is kind of a brief of Toucan. Once we walk you through the demo video, we'll get more details about how Toucan basically functions. So the second topic was basically stakeholders. So when I say stakeholders, I basically mean who are all the people who are basically linked on Toucan. So if we see the first person that is important, that basically needs Toucan, is the customer. So the customer basically places an order, that is the first person. Then the person admin, who is basically owning the business, he owns the business and provides the platform to the customers and other stakeholders. The second one is the admin. Then we have agents who are basically working in the field and making the deliveries or doing the home services, etc. So the agent is the third person. Besides that, there is manager. So what does manager do? So basically, for example, just assume we have a business of food delivery and which expands to various cities in a country, let's say in Delhi and Mumbai. So we have two businesses in Delhi and Mumbai both. So we'll be having two different teams working in Delhi and Mumbai, which will be having few agents in Delhi, another in Mumbai. So both the operations are very vast and cannot be handled by one admin. So what the admin does is basically he appoints two different people, one from Delhi and one from Mumbai. So they'll be looking into the business of their particular team, that is Mumbai or Delhi. So that person is called manager, who handles the team of a particular location. We can call that a geofence. I'll explain what is a geofence later on when we go further on in the video. So these are the basic stakeholders on Toucan, and let's see what are the interfaces which Toucans provide to these stakeholders for their interaction. So if we see, so first one is the dashboard. So admin can basically handle all these operations using this dashboard. And besides that, we also have a manager app. Let's see what is a manager app. So if you see, the admin also gets a manager app. So he can use either the dashboard or a manager app. Manager app can be used by the admin as well as his manager. So this is one app where they can interact with Toucan and handle the operations. So this is a manager app. Both manager and admin can use the dashboard as well as the manager app. They just get credentials for their own, and they can sign up, they can actually log in the dashboard as well as my manager app and overlook their operations. So that is the first interface. Then for the customer, we have a customer app. So this is a customer app from where they can book their orders. This is one interface. Besides that, there is also a booking form which from where he can book the orders. So this is kind of a web URL, so kind of a Google form where they can just place an order, and then the whole journey will be same as any other order placed on Toucan. So the admin gets a dashboard and the manager app. Customer gets a customer app or booking form, and manager also gets a dashboard and a manager app. And then there is an agent. So agent also gets an app, which we call Toucan Agent app. So this is basically Toucan Agent app, where the agent gets the request, performs the action, completes the task, and then finally the tracking is then sent to the customer as well as the admin. So this is the interface which the agent gets. So these are all the three apps which we have, and I've also shown you the dashboard and the booking form. So these are the interfaces and the stakeholders. Next, moving on to how to create a task. So there are various ways of creating tasks on Toucan. So it can be as simple as creating tasks from the dashboard. So as you can see, here is a window which you just open and create a task. Besides that, there can be various other ways. One can be from the customer app or the booking form, right? Then we have another way, which is basically this bulk import. So if there is, for example, the admin has so many orders coming in bulk from the customer, so they can just upload all those orders in a CSV. Put all those orders in a CSV and then simply browse this CSV and upload it here. So all the tasks will be created in bulk on the dashboard. So that is another way. And besides that, there is one more way, which is basically API integration. So for example, let's assume that someone already has a customer facing platform, say like Yellow of JungleWorks. So they have their own customer facing platform and they just want to integrate that their customer facing platform with Toucan. So what will they do is, we have open APIs on Toucan. So basically they integrate their customer facing platform with Toucan using the open API. So every request it's basically a two-way process. So all the tasks and requests from that platform are sent to Toucan via webhooks, via APIs, using the open APIs. And all the tracking and other information regarding the task are transferred to that platform using webhooks. So what are webhooks? I'll show you later on. So basically it's a two-way process where the request comes from the customer facing platform to Toucan, and then the information is sent to their platform using webhooks. So I think these are all the ways of creating tasks. Next, moving on to assigning of tasks. So assigning of tasks can be done by three ways. One is manual assignment, then is auto assignment, and then third is route optimization. So for example, a platform has very few tasks on the system coming every day, so they can manually assign it. So let's just assume that this is a task I've got on the dashboard. I just click on auto assign, I select a team, or I just assign it to one of the agents, right? So I'll just select the agent, I'll assign it. So that is manual assignment. The task has been assigned to George, right? So that is manual assignment. The other way can be auto assignment. So auto assignment is basically we have six auto location logics. So whichever suits your platform, you can use that logic and assign that task to the best eligible agent depending on that logic. So that is second way. Third way is route optimization. So route optimization, let me just show you this. So basically route optimization is something like, so just assume that you have 100 orders coming on per day and you have 10 agents working on your platform. So you want that all those orders should be distributed to between all those 10 agents to minimize the distance or time that is taken by the agents to fulfill those orders. So in that case, you use route optimization. So let me just explain to you the difference between route optimization and auto assignment using two use cases. So let's assume there is a food delivery. So in food delivery, there's a parameter which is called order fulfillment time. That is very important. So for example, if there is a person is ordering food, he wants it to be delivered as soon as possible. So let's assume, let's take the example of pizza delivery. So they had the whole marketing campaign going on, which was focused on 30 minutes delivery. So for them, the fulfillment time is very important. So they want the order to be delivered as soon as it is placed. So for them, route optimization is not a suitable option. They select auto assignment. But let's take another case of furniture delivery. So there are customers coming to the shop, they are placing their orders and they want their furniture to be delivered to their home. But it's not like just they have booked the order and they want the furniture to be delivered then and there. So they have a window like 1 day or 2 days that they will place the order and they want the furniture to be delivered to their home in a day or two. So for example, the furniture owner gets 100 such orders in a day and he'll be putting all the furnitures in a truck, and then the truck will deliver all this furniture to home, one house to the other. And for them, this is very important that the truck has to cover the minimum distance. For them, fulfillment time is not the major KPI. For them, it's important that once the truck is loaded with all the orders, he'll just go one by one and deliver it to the customers and covering the minimum distance or minimum time. So for them, distance is the major parameter rather than order fulfillment time. So for them, route optimization is a better solution rather than auto assignment. All right, so I think I have given you a brief about how route optimization and auto assignment can be used in different use cases. So I won't be covering the whole route optimization in this video. It will be covered when we see when we cover the extensions in the next demo video probably. So in this video, I won't be giving you much details about route optimization. All right, so I think I have given you the three ways of assigning tasks. So now let's go to the task journey. So basically creating a task, the process is same no matter where you create the task. I'll just show you how a task is created and how it's completed from the dashboard. So first is the first option that you get is admin and merchant. So basically I'll explain you what is a merchant later on. So let's first assume what is let's assume that we are booking a task for an admin. And the second option that we get is pickup and delivery appointment and field workforce. So these are basically what we call workflows on Toucan. So these are the three workflows. So if you see pickup and delivery, simple, it's a food pickup or delivery or any parcel pickup and delivery. That's the use case. In appointment and field workforce, appointment is basically like home services. So for example, if you order a home cleaning service, so they'll come to your house, clean the house, and then they'll go. So in appointment, if you see, there are two time stances, that is start time and end time. And if you select pickup and delivery, there's only one timestamp, which is basically pickup before. So in pickup and delivery, there's one timestamp that this task should be completed by this time. And in appointment, there's a time slot. So basically, I want someone to clean my house between 3 to 4, right? So that's basically the difference depending on the use case. And there's third that is called field workforce. Field work is basically for those use cases where your resources are working in field. Just assume as your marketing or salespeople or people who are going for surveys. So these are also these are included in field workforce. In field workforce as well, there's a start time and end time, right? So there's nothing more different, much difference in all these workflows. Basically, it's just about how what is your use case and the format is only the format. The only difference in the format is the start and end time. And in pickup delivery, you only get a one time, which is basically that a task should be completed by this time. So let's book an order for pickup and delivery workflow. So by the way, if you see, there are so many details to be filled while booking a order, but only time and address are the compulsory field. Rest are optional. So if you want to book, let's say, I'm booking an order for Akhil. I fill the details, right? I order ID and other details also I can fill. Order ID is basically any order, any ID which is which I want to assign to a particular task. So there's a randomly generated unique identification number that is called task ID, which is generated by Toucan. But besides that, if you also have some order ID of which is relevant to your business case, you can just put that ID as well. Just I have put any random ID. You can, there are other fields as well. So these are basically the fields which are relevant to any use cases. For example, it doesn't matter if I'm booking a home service app or a pickup and delivery app. I'll be having the customer's name, phone number, email address, and the address and time as well. But besides that, there are many other requirements which are more specific to a business use case. So let's assume I have a pickup and delivery use case. So I might be needing some more information like what is the search price or what is the label or any other field which is more relevant to my use case. So what I'll do is I'll just create a template and add those details in task creation. So what is the template? I'll give you detail later on. So it's just I'm showing you that just create a template and you can add further details which are more relevant to your use case. Right? So I have just filled the details. I'll also be creating a delivery task. I have filled the details, delivery time, and then I get an option over here for auto assignment. So in auto assignment, I can either define my teams, geofences, tags, and I can also like manually assign one agent, right? Or I can just select it for auto assignment. Right? I can select either of the options. I can also define then how many agents I want to assign. I can assign it to one agent, or I can just create, like for example, three agents. If I want three agents for one task, I can do that too, right? So I'll just select one and I'll create a task. So if you see, the task has been created. If I see my agent app, I've also got a notification on my agent app, right? So I can decline or accept the task. I'll just accept it. I can see the task in my agent app. I also get a notification on the dashboard, the task has been accepted, right? I can just click it. Then I have all the customer details and then order details, order ID, time. I can also chat with my customer, I can call him, right? If I click here, I'll get the navigation. I get the navigation, so basically agent will get the route which he should follow to reach that particular destination. See, I get the navigation as well. This is basically Google Maps. We just redirect the agent to the Google Maps. So let me just come to agent app. So once I start the task, then I can mark it as arrive. Once I have arrived, I have many other fields which I can use basically as proof of delivery. So I can add a note, I can take a signature from the agent, from the customer basically, right? I'll just add a signature. I have added the signature. Similarly, I can add an image. I can also verify it using a barcode. I can just, if there is a barcode on the order, I can just scan the barcode using this, and or I can manually enter it, right? And there are, these are the fields, like for example, so these were the fields which basically I could add in the task depending on the template fields, right? So once I have done all those things, I can just simply complete the order. This has been, pickup has been completed. Then I've been redirected to the delivery. I'll follow the same process. Start, arrive, I can collect similar signature images, etc. for the delivery task as well, and then finally mark it successful, right? So the task has been completed, and I was, as I was doing all these operations on the agent app, the similar and simultaneously the order was being moved to different stages on the dashboard as well. It has been moved to completed stage now, right? So this was basically a task journey. So when the task has been created, it was assigned to an agent, and then finally the agent performed the action, and it was simultaneously updated on the dashboard, as well as the customer will be also be getting the like tracking information and everything, right? So this was basically a task journey. Now let's move on to what was next, dashboard. So basically this is the dashboard, right? So if you can see, there are three main sections. One is the task panel, then there's map, and then there is finally the agent panel. So tasks are basically all the orders that are coming from anywhere, the ways which I've mentioned of creation of tasks. But they can be coming from anywhere, doesn't matter where the task is created, it all comes to on token and it will be visible on this section. So if you see, there are basically three stages on for every task, that is unassigned, assigned, and completed. So there's a difference between all the like stages and statuses. So if you see statuses, what are statuses? Let's see. So if you see change, if you see statuses, so we have, these are all the stages, statuses, that is unassigned, means the task has been created, but it has not been assigned to any agent. Then we come to assigned, then acknowledged means the agent has been assigned and the agent has basically accepted. Then started, in progress, successful, and there can be other options like failed, declined, or cancelled. So these are basically the statuses, and depending on the statuses, a task is moved between these three stages. So unassigned is basically the task has been completed, but it has not been assigned any agent. Next is assigned. So as an agent has been assigned, the task will move from unassigned to assigned stage, and till the task has been completed, means completed can be failed, successful, or declined, or cancelled. So these are the complete stages, and until and unless the task has been marked one of those statuses, it will be in an assigned stage, right? So these are all the stages. If you see, unassigned, assigned, and completed. and all the tasks, whether it is pickup and delivery or simple pickup or delivery, everything will be visible here. So one more thing which I forgot to mention, that on Toucan you can create a pickup task, a delivery task, a pickup and delivery task, or single pickup, multiple deliveries, multiple pickup, single deliveries. So all the combinations are possible. Only multiple pickup and multiple deliveries are not possible. So if I show you here, once you add a pickup, for example, I have added a pickup delivery. I have added a pickup delivery, right? I can add another pickup, or I can add another delivery. So if I want, I can add as many as pickup and one delivery, or if I want, I can add as many as deliveries and single pickup. So all combinations are possible except multiple pickup and multiple deliveries, right? And this is what about the task. Now let's move on to agents. So basically agents are your field service people who are basically performing the deliveries or operations. So you can name it as agents or whatever you call them, drivers or servicemen, whatever you want, you can call them. So these are three stages for an agent: free, busy and inactive. So free is agent who is online, that is on duty, but he does not have any task. In busy, so basically agent is online, but he has been assigned a task. And inactive is agent is off duty. So these are all the three stages. If you click here, you'll get many other details of the task of the agent as well. So when he was online last time, his name, contact number, last location and other information as well, right? You can see his timeline. So right now this agent has not traveled much, otherwise you'll get all the timeline in this map where he will be showing basically the path that his agent has been following, right? And you get the timestamps here as well. And if you see in the task panel, you see all the details of a task. For example, what are the details? You get all these details about the task. Whatever fields like earning and pricing, if it has been activated, you will get details about that too. All the custom fields in the template, you will see the details here. You'll get the customer details and you'll also get the history. For example, just if you see when the task was created, when notification was sent, who all got the notification, what are the stages, what are the like instances. And you can also, if you just click here on location map, you'll also get the location where this stage was marked and what was the time. Everything you'll be getting over the dashboard, right? If there is an attachment, for example, I just added a signature, right? So if I click there also, I can see the attachment as well, right? You get the time and how much distance was it covered. So everything is just mapped in the track, in the task history. You can also have many options like duplicate, export, delete, everything you can do from here. This is basically the task ID, which was a unique number generated for that task by Toucan. You can see this was pickup task ID, this was delivery task ID. So every stop, pickup is a stop, delivery is a stop, every stop has a unique ID, which is basically the task ID, right? So this was all the information about the task panel, agent panel, and then this is the map. So you can see all the map, you can zoom in, zoom out, everything. And you get the option, for example, there are a lot of tasks and you don't want to see all those tasks on the dashboard at a time, because it makes you a bit cumbersome to see all those tasks on maps. So you can hide the irrelevant tasks. For example, all those completed tasks you don't want to see, or if you want to hide the offline agents on the map, so you can just select these options and do whatever you want. You can customize basically your map, right? Then coming up to this tab, so we have map view and list view. So this was the map view. If you want to see the list view, this is the list view. So this is the list view where you see the same details of the task in a tabular form, right? You have filters here as well, so you can just filter the task based on their statuses, and you have tags as well. So let me explain you what is a tag. So basically just assume that you have a variety of agents. So for example, you have electricians, you have home cleaning people, and you have massage service agents, right? So you have three categories of agents. Just let's take two. One is electrician and one is home service. So there are two categories of agents which you basically, two kind of services which you provide. So for example, and in that case, there are orders coming for home service, there are orders coming from electricians. So you want that the order coming from electricians should be mapped with the electricians, right? And if you the orders coming for home services should be mapped with the home service agents, right? Because that's their eligibility. A home service agent cannot do the job for electrician. So this is where the tags come in useful. Tags are useful. So for example, once you are creating a task, you just assign that tag. So let's say home service is a tag. So just while creating a tag, you assign that tag to that task, and you have also assigned tags to the agents. So home service agent will get home service tag, electricians will get electrician tag, and corresponding tags will be mapped while creating the task. So the home service task will be assigned only to the home service agents, and correspondingly for the electrician. So this is how where the tags come in place. They basically maps the request of one type with the agents of that type, right? So this is what tags does. And you have other option, like you want to export all this tasks, you can do at once. You have many other filters here. So there are so many fields. If you want to see all of them, you can just select all of them. Otherwise, if you want to hide many or some of the fields which are not relevant to you, like many businesses do not have order ID, so they'll just hide it here and you won't see the order ID field in this column, right? Then there's merge connected task. So what is merge connected task? So if you see, there is pickup and delivery task, every stop is shown here as separate, right? But there can be many tasks which are pickup and delivery, right? Or pickup and multiple deliveries. So if you want to see all those connected tasks as one column, one row, just enable this. So what you'll see is now all those connected tasks, for example, I had created a pickup and delivery task, right? So this pickup stop and delivery stop will be shown in one row. So this is how connected task works, right? Then coming up to other filters which we have. So this is basically the date filter. You can select a particular date and time for all the tasks to be visible for that particular duration. And then we have teams filter. So basically teams are like, just as I explained to you, there can be a Chandigarh team or Delhi team and Mumbai team. So if you want to see all the teams operation at once, you can just select all teams. Or if you want to see, like for example, I want to see the operations of San Francisco only. So I'll just select San Francisco, and the all the tasks and agents of San Francisco will be visible on the dashboard. So this is how team filter works. And this is filter basically for admin and merchant. So okay, let's discuss what is a merchant. So basically I have explained you that if a person has business use cases in different geographies, he can use teams, right? So merchant, what it basically does is, let's take an example of Zomato. So what is Zomato? Zomato is a marketplace, right? So Zomato owns a marketplace of food delivery, and there are many other restaurants registered on Zomato. For example, Pizza Hut or McDonald's, these are all restaurants, right? So a marketplace has many restaurants registered, and those restaurants can be mapped on Toucan as merchants. So Pizza Hut and McDonald's are merchants on Toucan, and Zomato is the admin dashboard, right? So all the operations of a merchant are included in the admin's operations. So you must be confusing between what is a manager and what is a merchant. So let me just give you explanation on that. So manager is basically an employee of the admin, right? Because admin is just segregating his business from different geographies by appointing managers and teams. So he is basically an employee of the admin. But if you see merchants are not employee of the admin. Zomato does not own Pizza Hut or McDonald's. He's just providing a platform where they can perform their operations. He's just basically kind of an aggregator, right? He does not own the business. He's just giving them a platform for performing their operations. So this is what a merchant is. So if the admin has many other merchants, for example, I have one merchant named Rahul. So if I want to see the tasks which are mine, I can see here. And if I want to see the tasks which are basically of merchant Rahul, I can see from here. So I'll just select Rahul from this drop down. I can see all the operations like task and agents of Rahul, right? So a merchant also gets a dashboard similar to this. He will have his own credentials. He can just log in and see all his operations, same as admin or merchant. He can also use the manager app for the same. I think I've clarified what is a merchant and manager. So let's move on to all the menu sections which we see here. Oh, sorry, I have missed a few things. So this was the create task button. You can just click here and see bulk import as well. Then this is basically the section where you see sorry, where you see all the extensions. So extensions, basically these are like a few add-ons on Toucan, which are very like business specific cases. For example, if we have so many payment gateways and SMS gateways integrated with Toucan, but every payment gateway and SMS gateway is not used by every person. So for example, Stripe is very popular in almost 25 to 30 countries all over the world. So those people will be using Stripe for their payment, but in India it's not popular because it's not available in India, so they'll be using some other payment gateway. So depending on the use case, people select the extension, enable them on Toucan, and it functions smoothly, right? So depending on the use case, just you can just select one extension, enable it on Toucan, and it will be integrated automatically, right? So for example, let's take off Toucan booking forms. Toucan booking form is one of the extensions, right? Where this, I had shown you what is Toucan booking form. So this was a Toucan booking form. So many clients would be wanting to have this booking form for their task from the customers, right? But a lot of them won't want because they have a customer app or they have a way where they simply bulk import the dashboard. So this is very specific for the customer. So if he wants it to be enabled for his dashboard, he can just go and enable Toucan booking form. Others won't do this. So this is basically depending on your requirement. You just go on extension, select it, enable it, and it will be integrated. So this is how extensions work. Regarding every like important extension, we'll be covering in the next demo video. And here is the notification button where basically you get all the updates from the product. So whatever we release on the product, we'll just keep like add here as an update, and you can just click there and see more details about it. So I think I've covered mostly about the dashboard. Now let's go to the menu sections, right? So this was the dashboard. Next we go to the agent section. So agents are basically your delivery people or servicemen, whoever are performing the actions. So you get a list of all the agents which are added on the platform. If you want to add an agent, you have these fields which are by default for every agent, right? And these are very common for every use case. But besides that, if you have like a white label solution, rebranded solution, you can also have a sign up template. So basically sign up template is where you can add any additional information which you want for your agent. You can just add it here, and you'll see another option here that is additional information if you have enabled the sign up template. And all those information can be collected from the agent while he's signing up, and you can see all those details here. So for example, let's assume that there is a pickup and delivery business case, and they want the driver license and other documents as well, so to be added while the agent is signing up. So they'll just add those custom fields in the template, and the agent will upload the document, and they can see over here. So these are the fields which are very important for the agents. As I explained you, tag. So tag is one of the field which can be used for mapping the task and agent. So if I add a freelancer tag, I'll be just adding the, you can assign a team, right? Other fields I'll just explain when I explain the settings section, right? So this is basically a add agent pop-up box where you add the information just and fill the fields and then add it, right? So these are all the agents. I can import a sheet of agents, export it. I can filter the columns and do whatever I want. I can also filter by like captive and freelancer agents, which I'll be explaining later on what is captive and free agents. Now merchant I've explained. So merchant is again like I've added Rahul as a merchant. So this is all the, these are all the details of merchant. I can add a merchant by filling all these details. Moving on to customers. So I can add customers or automatically whoever is booking a task on Toucan, he'll be added as a customer over here. So if a task coming from customer app or booking form or anywhere, the customer will be automatically added in this list. And you can see all the information about everybody who has booked a task anytime on Toucan, right? I can add a customer as well. I can import, export, I can do anything I want. Next, moving on to analytics section. So analytics section is basically where we get a bird's eye view or any details about the operations which is going on. So this is the like overview of all the tasks which are being performed on Toucan. I get the status, agent statuses, and other like parameters, total task efficiency, productivity, time-based productivity, etc. I have many other fields here. like related to task, the performance of agents and task effectiveness. All these are basically KPIs which are tracked for every task on Toucan and every operation that is performed by our agents. I can also, if I want, I can request a report. For example, these are standard reports which is visible to every dashboard. But if I want any specific customized report which is specific to my use case, I can just request it and that will be added over here. Next, this is HippoChat. This is basically an extension which enables the communication between the customer, agent, admin, and manager. So these are all the stakeholders and they are basically, they can communicate using HippoChat. It's basically an extension and I'll give you more details about HippoChat when we discuss the extension section in the next video. So this is basically HippoChat. I can see all the chats between all my stakeholders on the dashboard. Extensions, I've already explained what is that. Then there is support, where if you want to communicate any, or if you have any requests with JungleWorks or Toucan, you can just click here and have a communication with us. Next, moving on to settings. So this is very important and this is where you need more details about everything. So these are all the sections in settings we'll be discussing one by one, right? So first, moving on to preferences, I've already explained what are workflows. You can select any one of them, pick up appointment or field workforce, whatever suits to your business. Then I can customize my agent panel. So I have shown you the agent panel, right? So if you want, like, what are the fields information which should be displayed on the agent panel, you can just customize it. Then there is tracking panel customization. Tracking panel is basically, so for example, your customers might be booking orders from anywhere, right? So if they don't have any other interface from Toucan, for example, the customer booking form or the customer app, so we also send the customer like order tracking using SMS or email. So basically there's a tracking link which is a URL and it has the UI of tracking the agent. So we send that tracking link through SMS or emails to your customer on their phone number or email ID and they can see that live tracking of the order. So what will be the basic UI of that tracking link, we can customize it from here. Map configuration, so we basically have two maps, that is Google map and flight map, which is internal which is our internal map. So you can select either of them, you can select Google map or flight map and just integrate it over here using the keys. Then you can have default view as map view or list view. So by default it's map view. If you want the list view to be your default view, you can do that too. Time settings, you can just select like theme settings. Basically you can do whatever theme you want, like this black color or these all the theme colors, you can customize depending on your choice. Missions I'll be explaining you later on. You can configure the date and time format, distance as well, and these are some like keys depending on the customer data protection. You can just enable it if you wish. And there's delay setting as well. If you see the dashboard, I'll just select the admin. So if the task is delayed, that is it has crossed the time which was assigned to that task, you will see that the task will be, there will be a delayed option shown corresponding to the task. So this task has crossed its time limit and there you see a delayed option here. So this is when you see, have enabled that section of delay setting in the preference. Next, moving on to tracking link settings. So you can just these are the settings related to your tracking link, which is basically for the order tracking for your customer. So if you want to enable ratings for in your tracking link, so once order is completed, the tracking link becomes a rating link, so the customer can rate your order or the agent then and there. And if you, for example, if you have many other connected tasks, you can enable give one tracking link for all those connected tasks. Then auto-allocation. So auto-allocation can be for one auto-allocation logic for the whole system, or you can have different allocation logics for every team. So that can also be done. So if you have enabled, you'll be getting every different allocation logics for every team. Then there are geofences. So what are geofences? So basically geofences can be used to segregate your business in different geographies. So for example, you have operations in Chandigarh, Delhi and Mumbai, right? So if there is an order coming from Delhi team, so Delhi geofence, you want that order to be mapped with the agents who are working for Delhi team, right? So what you will do is just assign a geofence to that order So whenever an order is coming from Delhi, a geofence of Delhi will be assigned to that task, and only Delhi agents will be getting those requests. So this is how geofence works. And again, you can select the geofence, which can be the parameter can be pickup or delivery. If you want the pickup to be parameter for geofence, you can select pickup or delivery. You can do that. Next, moving on to profile section. So these are all the basic information about your account. You can do that, add whatever you want. You can change the email ID. So user ID is a unique ID which is basically generated by the token, and you cannot change that. Rest of the fields, email IDs and everything, you can change whenever you want. And again, this customize agent text, for example, this is agent, which is called by default. You can call them your drivers, right? So if I click here as drivers, so all the agents will be called as drivers or whatever you want. You can just text it here. There are other fields, for example, change language, password, delete and everything. You can just see there. Next, coming to templates. Templates are really, really important feature on Toucan. So templates are used at different places. For example, the most common use cases while creating a task. Then there can be a use case for agent signup, right? And for earning and pricing as well. So for example, just let's take the case of basically task creation. So just as I explained you while creating the task, that for example, there are a few standard fields which are relevant to every business use case, like customer name, email, phone number, address and time. So these are standard fields which will be required for any order. But let's take an example of food delivery, where you'll be having fields like tip or any other field which might be relevant to that use case. So in that case, you add those additional fields in this template. So we have some standard templates. Just take a for example of food delivery, right? So this is a standard template for food delivery, where I might need the delivery cost, total payment method, custom fields, etc. for that particular order. So let's see. So these are all the fields required in that template, right? So I can just create a template here, and while I'm creating the task, I'll just attach this template to that task. So all these fields will be attached to that task. So I can just add a field. So for example, delivery cost, I can add it as whether it is a read and write or hidden field. So for example, if I select as a read only, so agent will only be able to read it. He won't be able to edit it, right? And if I select here as read and write, he'll be able to edit as well. So for example, there might be fields which are just for information of the agents. So for example, what is the cost? What is the total cost that has to be collected from the agent, right? No, this one. For example, this is the total cost, right? So I would just want the agent to see that this is the total cost which has to be collected from the agent. So I'll just keep it as read only. And then there is some fields like, for example, tip. For example, tip, right? So I want the agent to add a tip that this customer has paid you this much tip. So that can be read and write as well, right? And besides that, there can be many fields which are just for my information. It is not related to the agent. So I'll keep it as hidden so that I can see those fields, but the agents won't be able to see that field, right? I can select what kind of field that is. For example, date, time, drop down, email ID, phone number, anything can any field type can I can select, right? I can add the value. I can make it as mandatory, so for example, read and write. I can make it as mandatory or non-mandatory, whatever suits me, I can do that, right? So I have created a template, and then I'll add that template to task, right? Similarly, if I want to collect some information while the agents are signing up. So again, there are two ways of adding an agent. So one is I add it from the dashboard, which I'd already explained to you. Other is where agents can sign up on their own. They'll just download the app from the Google's App Store and sign up, right? So that is basically for just for the white label client. So they can just download the app from the Play Store, fill all the information and sign up, right? If I want to enable verification, the admin can just enable the verification, and the agent's request will be placed on Toucan. But until and unless I've approved the request, they won't be added on the platform, right? And whatever fields I want to be collected while they are signing up, I can just create a template for that and assign it as a sign up template. Again, then coming to add pop notification. So for example, there are few fields which I want to be displayed while the task request is coming. So for example, there are a few orders for which the delivery charges will be 100 rupees, and for others there will be 50 rupees, right? So that field, for example, delivery cost, right? Delivery cost is one of the field. So I want that field to be displayed while the agent is receiving the notification. So he'll, if I select here as delivery cost as add a pop-up notification, the agent will be seeing the delivery cost right in the task request. And if he's okay with the delivery cost, he'll accept it, otherwise he won't. So if I want to show any field that is in the custom field in the task notification, I'll select it as an add pop notification. Payment invoice template. So payment invoice template is basically, so this is an invoice template which is visible on the task screen once the agent has completed the task. So I can have any format of my choice. I can just create the format, and that format will be visible on the agent screen once he has completed the task. Now coming to task pricing and agent earning. That is a very, very important feature on Toucan, and it is kind of one of the most used extension on Toucan. So task pricing and agent earning. Task pricing is the price which I charge my customers, and agent earning is the delivery charge which I'm paying to my agents, right? So basically we can create rules for pricing and earning, and this is the pop-up box where I fill my fields, and the rule, according to the rule, the value is calculated. And can place any rule name, right? Like task pricing, I can define here till what decimal places the value has to be round off. I can use this rule for agent earning or task pricing, whichever I want. And right now I'm creating a rule for task pricing, right? I can apply it for all the tasks or few selected tasks. If I select few selected tasks, I can create those rules for geofences. For example, I want to have different pricing rule for Delhi and different pricing rule for Mumbai. So I can just select this rule is valid for geofence, whatever geofence I have. For example, I don't know what name I gave. So there's a geofence named one. So this rule will be valid only in that geofence, right? And there is tag as well. So for example, I want to have different pricing depending on the tags. So I can do that too, right? These are basically customer tags. So I can just define tags for customer, and depending on their tag, there will be a rule valid for them. So I can do that, right? So now coming up to the parameters. So these are all the 8 parameters depending on which the pricing or earning rule is calculated. So these are all the parameters, but let me just give you the explanation with using a use case, right? So for example, let's take an order of a taxi ride. So taxi ride, if you see, so when you just book a taxi ride, if you are just sitting in the taxi, it doesn't matter if you travel for 1 kilometer or you have just traveled for 500 meter, they'll charge you a fixed fee, that is just assume 50 rupees, right? So if you have just booked the taxi, you have onboarded on the taxi, they'll charge you a fixed fee, that is 50 rupees. It doesn't matter you travel 1 kilometer or 500 meters, right? And after 1 kilometer, they'll charge you at a fixed rate. So for first kilometer, there'll be 50 rupees, and after that, there'll be 25 rupees per kilometer, right? So how do you fix it? So in that case, my base fare will be 50 rupees, and base distance will be 1 kilometer. And then after that, their charge is 25 rupees per kilometer. So I hope you understand this case, right? So base fare is 50 rupees. That is, at least for 1 kilometer, I'll be charging you at least 50 rupees. And after 1 kilometer, I'll be charging you 25 rupees per kilometer or mile. So I have selected here mile as my distance unit. So per kilometer or per mile, the average fare will be 25 rupees beyond 1 kilometer. So that is how base fare works for distance. Similarly, for duration as well, you can have similar logic. So for example, there is a home cleaning service that I'm asking for, right? So for 1 hour, so let's say here 60 minutes, right? For 60 minutes, I'll be with base duration. The base fare is 100 rupees, and beyond that, base fare is, for example, 100 rupees, and beyond that, the duration cost will be 50 rupees. So this is what, like, for 1 hour I'll be charging you 100 rupees for the service, and if you exceed beyond that, I'll be charging you 50 rupees per minute, right? So that is how the charge is. It shouldn't be 50, obviously that's a lot, but let's say 55 rupees per minute. So the charge will be 100 rupees per 60 minutes, that is first hour, and beyond that I'll be charging you 5 rupees per minute. So that is basically a use case for home service or any other use case which charges based on duration, right? Again, there is few other parameters like waiting fare. So for example, let's take a case of logistics business. So I'm having a logistics business and a truck is basically delivering order from one place to another. So in case of logistics businesses, waiting time is a very big problem. For example, the bus is just arrived on the warehouse, but it has to wait for 1 hour or 2 hours just for loading or unloading, right? So for them, waiting time is also a very crucial parameter. So what I'll do is, for base parameter, for example, base waiting time is 60. So I assume that 60 minutes is a decent waiting time for my logistics business. But if I have to wait more than 60 minutes, I'll be charging you 5 rupees per minute, right? So that is waiting fare. So if my truck is standing at your warehouse for more than 1 hour, I'll start charging you for all this waiting time. So this is how all these parameters can be used to configure the rule for different use cases. And depending on the use case, you can just have a combination of these parameters, create a rule for you, and you can have a rule for your task pricing or agent earning. Even for agent earning, the rule is same. For these parameters are same. Even for task pricing and agent earning, the parameters are same, right? So if you see, for example, for here agent earning, you can apply it for particular geofence or for particular tags, right? So for example, if you want to have an agent earning rule for Chandigarh and Delhi different, you can just set different rules for all those agents. If you want to have like different rule for different tags, for example, if I want to have different rule for my home service agents and a different rule for my electrician, so I can set different rules depending on the tags as well. Then I can calculate the path depending on the original distance or the estimated distance, whatever I wish. Apart from that, there is one more thing that is called add field of a template. So these are all the values. So just assume that there was a delivery charge which was calculated depending on the distance traveled by the agent. But beyond that, I also want the tip field, which is entered in the task, to be added as additional parameter in the earning. So for example, that tip field is one of the fields in the custom fields, right? So once the tip is, for example, 10 rupees and whatever value has been calculated by that rule, I'll just select here at, right now it's not added in the field. Let me just show it how it is done. So let's see, this was tip. It was read and write field, it was a number field because tip is a number, that is a value of money, right? So if I want to add a value of tip here, sorry, it's not showing up. I forgot which was the food delivery, right? I think it's not updating because it's already already available template, so it's not able to change it. But if you are creating a custom template, so basically you will have a field in the custom field which will be a numeric field, and for example that can be tip. So you can just import that field over here, and that value will also be added apart from these parameters. So for example, there is a tip field, I'll just import it here. That value will also be added over and above whatever earning I have been calculated depending on that rule, right? So that additional field can also be imported in that earning or pricing rule, and I can add that in the value which has been calculated by this formula which I have created. Besides that, we have deduction. So deduction is basically, for example, I am for any task, I have 100 rupees that is coming up as the delivery fee, out of which I can just charge like 30% as my commission, and rest of will be paid to the agent, right? So whatever value is being calculated as a delivery fee, I can charge a percentage of that as my commission, and rest of that will be credited to the agent. Then I can also set the maximum limit for the earning and pricing. For example, there is a case where I want to charge delivery fee, but I won't charge any delivery fee above 100 rupees. So I can just set the limit. So whatever value is coming from this formula, it will be below 100 and won't exceed 100 rupees. So I can set the limit as well. Right. So I think I have given you a brief explanation of how earning and pricing work. This is really, really important for every business use case, because obviously there'll be charging some money from the customers and paying a portion of it to their agents. So this is relevant for every use case. Now coming to geofences. So as I have already explained, so basically if you want to segregate your business in different geographies, you can create a geofence. For example, I have just created here a geofence for Chandigarh, right? So I have marked the region over here. If I want to add another geofence, I'll just name a geofence, for example, Chandigarh. I can add a jurisdiction as well. I'll just mark the region. Just assume this is the region which I want to mark as my geofence. So this is the region has been marked. I can assign a particular team. For example, if I want to assign the entire team, I can assign the entire team to that geofence. Or if I want to assign a particular few agents, I can do that too. So all the list of the agents in that team will be coming here, and I can assign, I have different teams, right? So I can just assign that particular agent or the entire team to that geofence, and the request will be mapped as per the geofence. So this is how geofence works. Next, coming to auto location. So this is the most important feature of Toqanify, I guess, and obviously it's not very easy to understand. So we'll be discussing all those logics which we have on Toqan one by one. So again, I've told you that if I've enabled team level auto location, I'll be able to select the allocation logic for a particular team, and every team can have different allocation logics. So that's one way. If not selected, you'll be having one allocation logic for all your teams. So let's go by one. So first, one by one is something like the request will be first sent to the nearest agent from that location, then it will move to the next agent, then next agent, until and unless it is assigned to a particular agent, right? And we have few parameters, that is request expires in second, means there's the time where the agent gets to accept that task. So once the agent has received the request, there'll be a timer going on, and within 30 seconds that request will expire and move on to the next agent. Number of retries is number of agents which through which it goes, the request goes. For example, I've given here 8, so the request will go to 8 agents until and unless it is assigned, and if none of those agents, 8 agents have accepted, the task will go as unassigned. Then we have two other parameters which will be common to all the allocation logics. One is default and captive agents. I'll be explaining this in the next freelancer feature when we discuss that. And then there is start allocation before time. So what this parameter does is, let's assume there's an order coming for food delivery, right? So food delivery orders are placed generally for instant delivery. For example, I'm booking an order for lunch. I want that order to be delivered right now, right? So I want, as soon as the order is created, the auto allocation should start, right? So this is 0 for all those cases. But in cases where there are future deliveries, for example, I want a furniture delivery or a food delivery for this case, I have booked an order for cake delivery tomorrow, right? Because the birthday tomorrow, I have booked the order right now, so that the admin and the restaurant gets an information that I have delivery for tomorrow. But once the order has been booked, the restaurant gets a notification for preparing the cake. But the agent should not be notified right now, because if the agent gets notification, the allocation will be based on current times and agent location, right? For example, I have booked a cake delivery order at my location in Chandigarh, sector 17, right? So if I assign the agent right now, the agent who is nearest to my location right now will be assigned the task. But tomorrow, when the task has to be actually delivered, he might be somewhere else, right? So this doesn't make sense for future delivery. So we define a parameter here, for example, 30 minutes. So if we define 30 minutes, so the order will be assigned, will be sent to assignment just 30 minutes before the actual time, task time. So tomorrow, if the order has been booked for 6 p.m., the order will be sent to auto location at 5:30. So agent will be notified at 5:30 that there is an order for sector 17 Chandigarh and you have to deliver that order. The task will be visible to admin dashboard as soon as I place the order, but the agent will be notified just 30 minutes before the order actual time. So these two parameters are common to all the allocation logics. Next, moving on to send-to-all. Send-to-all is all over, all the agents who are eligible for these orders will be sent the request at once, and whoever accepts the request, it will be assigned to them, right? Again, we have these parameters which are common to all, and then there's request expiry time as well. Then coming to batch-wise allocation logic. So this is the most popular logic which we have on Toucan, and not just on Toucan, in fact, almost every on-demand business uses batch-wise mostly. So it's most common allocation logic for everywhere. So let me just give you a brief explanation of what is batch-wise. So batch-wise is something like the request goes in batches. So there's a batch created of a particular radius, and there is an increment of that radius after every time. So this, let's say these are three parameters, that is distance parameter, start radius, maximum radius, and incremental radius. So for example, right now the start radius is 5 kilometers, there's an increment of 0.1, and the maximum radius is 10 kilometers. So as soon as the order is received, there will be a batch created of 5 kilometer radius, and all the agents within that 5 kilometer radius will get the notification of the task, right? And there's another parameter in time setting, which is batch processing time. So batch processing time is 20 seconds. So after 20 seconds, if no agent has accepted the task, a new batch will be created with this incremental radius, that is 5.1. So next batch will be created of radius 5.1, and all those agents within that radius of 5.1 will get the notification. And these radius keep increasing after the batch processing time until and unless we reach 10 kilometer radius. Either we reach the 10 kilometer radius, or either an agent has accepted the task, right? So these requests are sent in batches of radiuses, and agents are selected depending on the batch. There are a few other parameters as well. I have already explained batch processing time. Then there is request time, which is again the time which agents gets to accept or decline that request. Then there is batch size. Batch size is the number of agents who should get a request in one batch. So for example, I have set here as 10, right? So there might be possibility that in the first batch there are 20 agents, but if I have set the batch size as 10, so the request will be sent only to 10 agents at once, and then the next batch will be created. So that's how I define the batch size. And then there's maximum batch limit. Batch limit is the number of batches which should be created. So if I say this is the first batch, the second batch, and so on. So if I have defined as 5 limit, then the 5 number of batches will be created. And again, there is a retry. So retry is something like this: is if I start from one first batch and go on till 5, that is one retry. If none of the agents have accepted in the first retry, I'll start again from the beginning and just go on one after another batch. So these are retries. I can define as maximum as 8 retries in one auto location. Then there is delay settings. So delay settings are something like, if I want to prioritize my free agents over my busy agents, I can use this. So for example, if I set here as 10 seconds, so basically if there are two agents, one is busy and with one task and other one is free, so if I want to give the priority to the free agent, I'll set here as 10 seconds is the delay notification. So once I receive the task, the free agent will get the notification then and there, but the busy agent will get a notification with a delay of 10 seconds. 10 seconds is multiplied with the number of tasks which I already have. So if I have one task, the delay will be 10 seconds. If I have two tasks, the delay will be 20 seconds. Depending on the number of tasks, the delay will be multiplied with the number of tasks. So that is delay settings, which basically prioritize your free agents with the busy agents, because obviously the agent is, if the agent is free, he'll be able to deliver the task much earlier than the agent who already has the task. I can also define the maximum delay and maximum number of tasks which an agent can have. Then there is this pooling feature. So pooling is very common if you see other services as well, like Uber or Ola or any other ride services. They also have pool and pool or share, which we call them. So basically two orders, if they are lying within the range of the parameters which I have defined here, they will be pooled and assigned to one agent. So how the Uber pool works is, but for example, if there's one ride going on from one location to another location, and there's another ride coming nearby the route of that first task, the second task will also be assigned to the same driver, and both that or task will be completed by the same driver. So these are all the parameters which you define for pooling, and if those tasks satisfy those parameters, those tasks will be pooled and assigned to one agent. So let's discuss the parameters one by one. So there are a few parameters for distance. The first one is the threshold radius. Threshold radius is maximum distance between the agent and the second pickup. For example, I have already been assigned a task, I have started it, right? So I'm just about to deliver my first task, but then and there there's second task coming off for pooling. So I'll first check the distance between my current location and second pickup, right? So that it's to ensure that I'm not very far, I've not traveled a lot, and I have to come back to another location for the pickup. So it just ensure that if the location is within 5 kilometers of that my current location, then only the second pickup will be assigned or pooled to me. So this is the threshold radius. Besides that, we also have like parameters like the maximum distance between the two pickups or maximum between the both deliveries. So these are also the parameters, distance parameters. Then we have SLA. SLA is basically the total time which the task should take. For example, in pizza delivery, there's a SLA of 30 minutes, right? So if I define the, let me first enable it. So if I define the SLA as 30 minutes, so only those tasks will be pooled when both the tasks take the 30 minutes time to complete. So if there is a task and another task coming up, if I pool, that will exceed the 30 minutes of SLA, that won't be pooled, right? So this is the time how we define the SLA. Then there are ETA at pickup and then waiting time at first pickup, which are also the parameters for pooling, right? So configuring all those parameters, I can set my pooling logic, and then the task will be pooled, and this can improve the efficiency of the drivers and reduce the cost of operations. And then there is this parameter called send push to busy agents first. So this is basically prioritizing that in pooling, you want to push the notification to your busy agents, or you want to randomize it. Depending on that, whatever choice you have, you can just select it. So if you want to prioritize your busy agents, select yes. If you want to randomize between busy and free agents, select no. So this was batch wise. Then we have round robin. So these two parameters, round robin and nearest available, these are forceful as allocation logic. So basically, so in round robin and nearest available, so the agents won't get an option, like multiple agents won't be assigned. There will be whoever is the best eligible agents, he'll be assigned the task. He does not get an option to like other agents won't get the option, like out of the two agents, one can accept it. The agent who is eligible will be assigned the task. Right. So how round robin works is basically there are two parameters while selecting the agents for round robin logic. One is distance, otherwise number of tasks which the agent already has. So the ratio is 4-6. So every agent who is eligible is given a rating based on these two parameters: number of tasks which he already has, and the other is the how far is the agent from the current location. And based on the priorities, the best agent is given the task. So this basically logic works is, for example, you have all the drivers who are working as your employees, right? So it doesn't matter that if every agent is just closest to the task, I'll be assigning all the tasks to them, because obviously I want to distribute the workload between all the employees which I have, right? So I'll be using round robin logic, in which I'll be distributing the load. I'll also want the fulfillment time to be less, but at the same time, I also want that the load has to be distributed between my employees, right? Plus, it also helps in the fulfillment time because if an agent has already so many tasks in hand, he won't be able to deliver the task in time, even if it's very close to the location, right? So I basically distribute, I use both these parameters, distance and number of tasks, and then I assign the agent depending on the priority, right? So 0.6 and 4-6 ratio is given to the number of tasks and the distance parameter, and who gets the best rating among all the eligible agents will be assigned the task. And there are a few other parameters. For example, if I enable this, the task will be assigned to offline as well as logged out agents. And so this other parameter, which is basically restart allocation if task decline. So this basically selects the agent and assigns the task. So even if that agent declines the task, if I have selected it, he'll be again, that auto allocation will run again and select the next best agent. Then I can also define the maximum distance for allocation logic. So beyond that distance, no allocation will be running. And priority to ideal agent. So this is another parameter. So for example, right now we have chosen two parameters, that is distance and the number of tasks. There can be third parameter, that is ideal time. So ideal time is something like the time for which the agent has been idle, means the time between his last task and right now. So that is the duration called as idle time. So I can give the priority to idle agents. So this idle time will be the third parameter that will be acting for the allocation beyond number of tasks and distance. So I can enable that too, right? And these are the parameters which are already there in other allocation logics as well. So this was round robin. Next coming is nearest available. So nearest available is whoever is the nearest agent, I'll just assign the task to that particular agent. And I have parameters like radius, and these are the common parameters for all those assignment logics. So this is again a forceful assignment. Next coming up is first in, first out. So first in, first out is basically built over and above the batch wise allocation. So all the parameters for batch wise are already there. But beyond that, there is additional feature which is there in, first out. So it works something like, so every request that is coming up is added in a queue, right? So for example, there's one order coming, then beyond that, there's another one, after that, there's another one. So there's a queue of orders. And until and unless the first order is assigned, other orders won't be pushed in auto assignment. So there's a queue. So until and unless the first order is assigned, others won't be pushed for auto allocation. So this is how the logic works. So the allocation logic will be same as batch wise. You can also see these parameters, these are same as batch wise, but the only difference is that there will be queue of orders and the assignment will be based on the time of which the task has arrived. There's another thing that is called clubbing in FIFO. So clubbing is basically for all those orders who have same pickup and nearby deliveries, all those orders can be clubbed and sent to one allocation, one agent. So clubbing is similar to pooling, but only thing is it is only for same pickup, right? So for example, all the pickups are from same location and deliveries may vary or nearby, then only the orders will be clubbed. And another difference is that pooling is only for two tasks at maximum, clubbing can be more than two, right? So you just define here the distance, delivery distance. So if I define here as 5 kilometers, so pickup will be same and delivery distances can be within 5 kilometer range, right? And order threshold time is basically the preparation time. So for example, there's an order coming and order will be pushed for clubbing only if I define here 30 minutes. So order will be pushed for clubbing only after 30 minutes of the order receivement, because 30 minutes is the preparation time of that order. Clubbing again reduces the operational cost and optimizes the operations. So I think I've given you explanation of all the allocation logics, and these are really important to understand the functioning of Toucan. Next coming up is freelancer. So freelancer is something, so just assume that I have few agents who are my employees and there are few agents which are basically working as freelancers, right? So obviously I want to prioritize my employees over my freelancer. So this basic freelancer function works in two ways. First is if I have a tag, so I define a tag for my freelancer. So I just give my freelancer one tag, that is freelancer, right? I can just have any tag. So right now I have given them a tag as freelancer. So all the agents will be given freelancer task, and all the tasks which are coming with the task freelancer will be assigned to freelancers, right? And how will that task be visible? Let me just show you. So if there's an agent which is a freelancer, he'll be getting an option over here there, which will be like a new tag of available task. So if he clicks on that, so he will be basically getting a list of all those tasks over here which are with freelancer tag. So it's not like they'll be assigned to that particular agent, but he'll get a list of all the tasks which are available for the freelancer, and they can accept those tasks anytime. So he gets a list of all those tasks which are basically meant for freelancer. So if there are, for example, just assume that I am getting 5,000 orders a day. So I have the capacity to fulfill 4,000 orders from my agents, but beyond that, when the rest of the tasks are coming, I want that to be assigned to freelancer. So after 4,000 tasks, all the tasks that are coming, I'll be giving them a tag of freelancer, and those tasks will be pushed to my freelancer agents. That is one thing. Another thing which you have seen in auto location, right? So this was this parameter. So if you select this one, that is the default works which I have explained till now. If you select this option, so what will happen is captive means the agents who are your employees. So if you select this option, so the request will be first sent to your captive agents, and if none of them accept it, then it will move to freelancer agents, right? So this is what how it works. Basically, prioritize your captive agents then over your freelancer agent. So if you selected this option, the logic will work as same, but first it will be assigned to your captive agents. If they don't accept it, then it will push to freelancer agents, right? Freelancer agents whom you have selected here as tags, freelancer tags, right? You can also define the geofences, maximum task allowed for a freelancer. Then there's agent subscription. So agent subscription is something like, for example, there is a home service business where there are agents, and you basically don't give them earning, but what they give you is a monthly subscription. Just assume that all the agents give you a monthly subscription of $100 for receiving task of receiving 1,000 tasks per month. So just create a plan which is something like just a gold plan, right? And maximum task is 1,000 and the validity is 1 month. So all those agents who have been given this subscription plan, they'll be getting maximum of 1,000 tasks for 1 month, right? And once they have exceeded this, either this validity period or this maximum number of tasks, they won't get any tasks, right? So this is kind of a subscription model where the agents pay you some amount in the beginning, you give them a subscription, and they'll get the task until unless they have expired their subscription plan, right? So this feature can be like very useful in some of the business cases where there's no earning, but they pay you a subscription fee for the services that they are getting, right? Then coming up here is teams. So basically teams, as I've already explained, so these teams can be based on geographies, based on their skills, or any other feature, any other eligibility feature based on which you want to segregate your business. So for example, if you want to have different teams for Delhi and Mumbai, you can have different teams here, add a manager to them, add the agents to them, right? That is how it works. Or if you want to have a team for electricians and another team for home services, you can do that too, right? So you can just click here, add a team, you can add tags as well, team address as well, team name, whatever you want, you can just do that. Then add managers. So every team can have one manager or more than one manager. So if you want to appoint one person as like kind of head of the operations of that particular team, you can just select them, fill all the details, and you can assign a particular team. For example, I want to add a team of San Francisco. I can just do that, right? I can assign him more than one team as well. And this is role, which I'll explain you in ACL how role works. So I'll just add a manager, assign him a team, and he'll be looking to the operations of all the operations of that particular team. So he'll get a similar dashboard where he'll see the operations of only his team, means the team which has been assigned to that manager, right? Coming up to agent app. So basically these are the features which define the flow for a agent, right? So for example, what are the options that are visible to agent for when a task comes? You can just define it. You can give them an option of accept to decline or acknowledge, or if you don't want to give them an option, you won't give. You can just select none, right? App milestones. So as I've already explained, there are milestones like accept, then arrive, start, arrive, and then finally successful or failed. So these are all the app milestones. We can, if you don't want to show them arrive button, you can just skip that. If you want to show them the cancel button, you can just do that, or hide them fail button as well. So you can do same thing. And for example, if you want to have some standard reasons for your fail or cancel task, for example, if you want to have that list of standard reasons for which, because of which the task can fail, you can just select those, all those regions over here. And agents, whenever they want to mark the task as failed or canceled, they'll get the list, they'll select one of the options and then mark it as failed. Successful distance restriction is basically, for example, if you want to verify, ensure that the agents mark the task successful only when they're within a distance range of the destination. For example, I want that the agent should be within 500 meters of the successful distance, then only he'll be able to mark it as successful. I can just do that, right? I can also have a limit of tasks which can be cancelled by an agent. Similarly, failed task limit I can also have. I can also have a limit of age, like task per customer. So for example, if I want to limit that from this customer, this agent should get only 5 tasks a day. So I can do that too. On-demand workflow is basically where I want that my agent should get only one task at a time. So if he's already busy, he won't be getting any other request, right? So this is basically something like ride services, where if my agent is already driving for a ride, he should not be getting another task. So it's something like that. You can just disable, if you want that customer agent to chat you don't want to have in the Hippo chat, you can just disable it here. Connected task views, basically views for all the connected tasks, how it will be visible for your agents in the app. You can just customize your view for connected task. You can also have geofence restriction for your agents. So for example, if you want that the agents will be able to switch on duty only when they are within the working geofence range. So that is basically a kind of verification that to ensure that agents are marking them on duty when they are within the working range. For example, if the agent is within, I would want that agent should be within the range geofence of Delhi, then only he'll be able to get the request, and then I'll just enable this, and here they'll be able to mark themselves as online only when they are within the geofence. And this is another feature where you can get an alert when the agent is moving out of that particular geofence. These are action blocks basically, which define that what are the proof of deliveries which you want to have when the agent completes the task. For example, like they can add note or image or signature or barcode or image caption, etc. So if I want to have them within while for completion of the task, I can add this. I can also make them as mandatory or non-mandatory. For example, if I want to have agent signature as mandatory field, I can just make it as mandatory, right? Or barcode verification as mandatory, I can just mark it as mandatory. So these are all the fields which are basically defining the flow for agents in their app. Agent schedule is basically an extension which basically defines that how which basically defines the working hours of an agent. So for example, if an agent is working from 9 to 5, I'll just mark him available as in those time intervals, and he'll be getting notifications of task only within that working hour range. Beyond that, he won't get any notification, right? Both the admin or the agent can mark it depending on if the agent has been given the permission to edit his manager like schedule, then he'll be able to get he'll get the visibility in the agent app also. Next, coming up to notifications. So notification is very important feature of Toqan. So basically, notifications are meant for all the customers. So we have SMS, email, or webhook notification. So depending on all the stages which we have for a particular task, we can send the notification to our customers. So for example, when the request is received, I can enable an SMS and email notification to the agent that yes, your request has been received, and the text can be configured from here. So for example, whatever text I want to configure, I can configure from here, email or SMS, and the customer will be notified on his phone number and email regarding his task has been received. Similarly, we have any other stages as well. Agent started, arrived, and whatever stages we have. For pickup as well as delivery, I can do that. So all those notifications can be sent to the customers. Again, there is one more thing, that is webhook. So I have explained to you earlier that whenever there is an integration, there is a two-way process. So the request from that platform is coming to Toucan via APIs, and we send the information back to that platform using webhooks. So webhooks is basically here. You can just configure the platform's URL and everything, and this information about the task status will be sent to that URL from Toucan using webhooks. So for all the stages, whatever is being updated for the task, you can send the information to that particular platform and the status will be updated there as well. So this is notification about pickup, delivery, and apart from that, we have some additional information. For example, there's add customer, agent, block agent, and whatever you have, you can send them notification via SMS or email or webhook. Additional to that, we have app notifications. So there are a number of notifications which are sent to the agents in app. So you can configure the text and whatever messages sent to the agents in app, you can just configure it from here. Next coming to is agent, not only agent, there's both agent and manager, ACL. So basically access control limit is something like, it defines what permissions do you want to give to your managers or agents depending on your requirement. So for example, I have one manager who needs to have access of Delhi as well as Mumbai team, and there are two other managers whom I want to give the access only for their particular team in Delhi or Mumbai, right? So I'll define the roles depending on that, and I can give them my permissions. So for example, I have all the permissions related to task, agent, customer, teams, settings, etc. So whatever permission I want to give them to that manager, I'll just define those parameters. So for example, this is the role of head manager, right? Head manager. I'll define all the permissions, whatever I want, right? And then create a role. So there's a role created for head manager, right? And whenever I add a manager, I'll just assign that role of head manager to that manager, and all the permissions which are for a head manager will be mapped to that manager, right? So this is how ACL works, where I define a set of rules for a particular role and I assign that role to the manager or agent whom I want to give that permission. So this is kind of very good feature which gives the flexibility in your operations to have different roles, different permissions depending on your choices or use case. Then there is form editor, which is basically booking form, which is an extension. I'll be covering in more detail when we discuss extensions in next video. Same is for customer app. I'll be covering in next video. SMS. So SMS is basically the SMS is sent to the customers, and I can use any of the SMS service which we have. So we have basically two options. If I don't want to use an SMS notification, that's okay. But if I want to use Bumble or personal SMS gateway, Bumble is basically an internal SMS service of Toucan, right? So if you want to use Bumble, you can just add the key of Bumble and start using it. Or if I want to have any personal SMS gateway, so these are all the SMS gateways which we have integrated, because every country might have different popular SMS gateways. For example, in India, Gupshup is a very popular platform for SMS. So in some other country, Twilio can be popular. So these are all integrated. I just need to add those, create an account on Twilio, right? If I want to integrate Twilio, I'll just create an account on Twilio, add those keys on this platform, and the SMS will be integrated. I don't need to pay anything to Toucan for SMS service. I'll just be paying to Twilio directly on my account, and the SMS will be on Toucan will be going through my Twilio account, right? So this is how it works. Video call is again an extension. Emails. So emails, basically the emails are sent via this email ID to all your customers. But if you want to have a white labeled email, I'll just create a request from here, and I can have an email ID of my own, and all the notification to my customers will be sent from that email ID. There is billing section where I get details of all my billing and accounts details. For example, here is my plan and my company name, my billing date, how many credits I have, how many tasks I have left. I can add my card here. I'll get all the invoices here, month wise. Whenever there's an invoice generated, I'll get a list of all the invoices over here. Merchant billing is something like if I've added a merchant on my account, I want my merchants to be charged, right? Obviously, because I explained to you that Zomato has many merchants registered on their platform, for example, Pizza Hut or McDonald's. So they are not their employees. Obviously, they are charging McDonald's or Pizza Hut for the services which they are providing. So if I added a merchant, I want to charge them directly using Stripe or any other payment gateway. So I'll just create a plan and start charging them for all the services that I'm providing. So this is where we configure the plans and add those plans to merchants. Account logs are basically logs where you get every information about any activity, like adding of agent, blocking of agents, or any other information, anything that is happening on my account, I'll get a log over here. User guide is basically, if you select, it's basically a guide of Toucan, which consists of all the detailed videos and explanation about all the features which are there on Toucan. So anytime you can just look at all those features and have a understanding of all those features. Next is developers. So developer is something, I can add anyone as my developer and they can work upon. So these extensions, as I've already explained to you. So these are all So these are extensions which are already available on Toucan, but we have also given a lot of freedom to our customers that if they want to build over and above Toucan, they can also do that. So you can add anyone as developer and they can add extension, they can build extensions on their own. So if you want to build on Toucan, just go there and you'll get many options of creating extensions of your own, right? So if you feel like there is an extension which I can build which is relevant to my use case, you can just create them as a developer and they can build over and above Toucan. And that extension will be integrated to your platform automatically. So these are API keys. Using these API keys, you can basically integrate your platform with any other platform. Maybe it's your like customer facing platform or any other platform. If you want to integrate, you can just use these API keys. And this is the logout button, so which basically logs you out. So I think I've covered almost everything on Toucan. If you have anything, any more doubts, just reach out to us, or you can comment, and we'll for sure reply you. And I think these are all the features which I've covered for on Toucan dashboard. Besides that, there are a lot of things to be covered, which we'll be covering in probably in the next video. We'll be discussing about the extensions and customer app, manager app, and many other features which I've missed, like missions. So all those are really important features and probably I will be discussing in the next video. I think this is more than enough for now. See you all. Thank you. Thanks a lot.